Well, Alex's study has firmly established the fact that ALK-positive non-small cell lung cancer patients should be treated upfront, not by crizotinib, not with crizotinib, but with alectinib. It was showing an improved progression-free survival. We will update the progression-free survival at the ASCO meeting, but it is amazingly long, and it prevents the emergence of the progression of brain metastasis. Knowing the high prevalence of brain mets in ALK disease, this is of really major, meaningful importance to have this reduction in brain disease progression or in brain disease. So Alectinib is a standard treatment. The question of this poster here was to wonder about the quality of life, because when you kind of introduce a new treatment, you have to be sure that it's safe and well tolerated, with the impact of on patient-related outcomes that might result from that. So the poster of Maurice Perrol about the Alex trial and the patient-related outcomes was showing basically more or less the same thing. Both drugs, crizotinib and alectinib, improve the health-related quality of life. Both of them reduce the symptoms which are due to the disease. This is more or less similar, but the duration of impact on both parameters, quality of life and reduction of symptoms, is of course longer with alectinib as compared to crizotinib. Interestingly, the parameters of tolerability were in favor of alectinib too. So we have a better strategy and probably a bit of better tolerated strategy too.